Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
We have Nilesh Shah, Managing Director of Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company, now joining in to talk about this market as it continues to hit historic levels. Nilesh, as we say hi to you, a perfect 38,000 on the Sensex on the screen. You know, a lot of people are wondering whether this is a rally that will build from here, whether it'll involve a newer set of stocks as well, more names, or whether it's just the best idea to stick to the tried and tested. What would your advice be to a lot of retail investors who are wondering whether to put in fresh money now or not?
One, it's a tricky market for investors. It's a market where quality is at a huge premium. Momentum is at a huge discount, but it doesn't look like stopping there. And there are very few pockets of values or opportunities. Clearly, this is a market where if you are investing, be ready to face volatility. Be ready to be a long-term investor. And if possible, try to come by a systematic investment plan or systematic transfer plan, which is regular investment over a period of time rather than lump sum. It's a market where few stocks have taken Sensex to this level, but there is a broad market where there is a fairly large correction, and hence one has to be really long-term approach to make money from current level.
Okay, Nilesh, good afternoon. Anuj this side. Interesting take on that. Over the last 2 weeks, you have seen the erstwhile leaders actually correct a bit. Kotak, for example, is about 10% off the highs. HDFC Bank has fallen quite a bit from the highs, though Reliance, of course, still remains at all-time high. In that sense, the way we are seeing corporate banks rallying and some of the infra stocks rallying, are you sensing first bit of broadening of this market?
Anuj, if you remember last time when we talked, I said small and mid-cap stocks should start making a bottoming out process over next 30 to 60 days. And it was more of a gut-filled talk because you could clearly see selling interest waning down and the valuation divergence between quality stock and not-so-quality stock was widening. So it was no rocket science to take a call that at some point of time the bottoming out process will begin. But clearly, if we take a slightly longer term view, let's say on a 1 year basis, the small cap index is still negative. Large cap is 13-14% up. And within large cap, there is a huge divergence where few stocks have, you know, moved up. My feeling is that it's a slightly tricky market from a trading or investing point of view. If you take solace in quality, looking at some of the negatives or adverse factors which can cap the upside, be it political uncertainty, be it slowing domestic flows, be it oil prices, be it global tariffs, then you are paying a huge premium for that quality or defensiveness. On the other hand, if you try to be adventurous, saying that there are more than 450 stocks which have fallen more than 30% from their 52-week high, and let me do a dive over there, you are taking the volatility risk on your side. And hence, my recommendation will be long-term, be ready to face volatility, and if possible, try to invest on a gradual basis rather than lump sum.
But Nilesh, invest right now in tried and tested ideas, ideas that have worked, where there is, you know, there's very consistent earnings growth. We were just discussing a business like Page Industries just before we managed to connect with you. So think of the tried and tested names and stay there. Or is this the time where you really go out there, be a little brave and try and, you know, look for value, whether it's in corporate banks, whether it's in beaten down cement names, infra names?
My guess is that you'll have to take that call based on what you are looking at. If you can take volatility on your side, if 10-15% correction from here wouldn't unnerve you, then certainly there is better opportunities in small and mid-cap stocks. But if you want to be safe, you want to build a portfolio which can withstand some of the events which I talked about, especially May 2019 election, then large caps will provide you solace. So go by what is your risk appetite. If you can take downturn, certainly small and mid-caps provide some opportunity. Not those small and mid-caps, you know, where governance issues are still debatable, where auditors are coming in and going out, where balance sheet is still, you know, questionable. Don't go into those counters, but some of the quality names which have fallen because of illiquidity, which has fallen because of some, you know, seller losing their hope or confidence, that area will provide better opportunity.
Okay, that area will provide better opportunity. I think Manappuram Finance's numbers have hit the wires. I think they're slightly below the estimate, the first number that I've seen. But I'll, you know, wait for my team to flash it because the copy is not very clear. It looks like the first number is not, you know, is below the estimate. But you know, as I said, I will wait for the team to flash those numbers. Nilesh, from here on, you know, we saw the numbers of July from mutual funds. A lot of people believe that the real test of the Indian investors would be to see their NAVs actually go into negative. You reckon we are prepared for that, or Indian investors prepared for that, and the SIP flows will continue?
So, Anuj, we are too heterogeneous country to make one statement. And clearly, there are many investors in India who are taking the negative volatility on their chin. They are able to withstand volatility quite nicely. In fact, November, December 2016, which was a last big correction other than in this year, we saw huge amount of flows coming in. But at the same time, over the last 3 years, we have seen tremendous growth in mutual fund investment community. We have now more than 1.7 crore unique investors. Not all of them are as matured and as intelligent as the experienced one. We will have some immature money, some greed money, some innocent money. And the responsibility is on mutual fund industry as well as distributor community to handhold these people and give them confidence that, look, volatility is part of equity market. We'll go up and down. In the past also, we have fallen 15-20% and yet recovered all those losses. So please continue to give us your time and money. From a flow point of view, Anuj, month on month, mutual fund flows are turning negative. But year on year, by and large, they have maintained positive growth. There were a couple of NFOs, including our own Kotak Mahindra Balanced Advantage Fund, which collected fairly good response. My presumption is that the August number will look, might be a little better than July, based on the NFOs. But there is no doubt that flows have started slowing down. The uncertainty of market is being felt by investors.
So the market's still holding on to gains, about 126 up on the Sensex, about 20-odd points, 24 points on the Nifty. Bank Nifty is still holding strong. We'll get you some market opinion. In the morning, we were in conversation with Nilesh Shah, MD and CEO of Envision Capital. We asked him for his view on corporate banks to begin with.
I still think probably one needs to wait for a few more quarters. I'm not entirely sure if all the bad news is entirely out there. We've seen these the corporate banks continuously say for almost now 3 years, and every quarter they come up and saying that the worst is over, and by and large everything seems to have factored in. But every quarter you kind of end up seeing that the slippages continue.
At one point the wolf actually came.
Yeah, so now you really don't know when that happens. But my sense is that overall I still think that there could be pain for maybe another 2 or 3 quarters or so. So I think if you're willing to look beyond FY19, and some of these banks are able to resolve some of the leadership issues which they have been facing, I think these are the two factors one needs to keep in mind. So I think if you have probably another 2 to 3 year horizon from here, maybe on a relative basis, they look attractive because of the valuations and the fact that these stocks haven't gone anywhere for now several years. So it's probably still a contra bet, I would probably think that.
You think the problem that the market had about the narrow nature is over, or you think it's going to be that kind of a year, the last 2 week rally notwithstanding?
I think that continues to be a concern. And I think that's something which will still continue for a few more quarters. I still think that rest of this calendar year, we'll continue to see the market displaying pretty much a similar behavior that it has been doing for most part of this calendar year. And that's because I still think that the retail participation has kind of come down significantly. Global investors continue to be cautious on emerging markets, including India. And I think that some of the global headwinds will kind of resurface sometime towards the end of this year. So I think keeping that in mind, you're still going to see this market behaving in a pretty narrow way, pretty much like what it has been for the last 4 to 6 months.
What about earnings season? What have you made of it? Any upgrades, downgrades that you're expecting going ahead in any sectors?
I think overall it's been a mixed bag. Though there have been some real strong pockets like technology, consumer staples, private credit players, I think this has really been a basket which has really displayed some very, very strong momentum in earnings. And it looks like that this momentum will continue for them still for a few more quarters. Versus that, some of the sectors linked to the core economy have really not done well. So if you really look at cement, the numbers still, there seems to be still a lot of margin pressure. The capital goods space, I still think that's again witnessing a lot of challenges. So I think sectors to do with the core economy face challenges. And then of course, the entire consumer appliances space, they have been having weather-related problems. So they've had some really weak quarters. So I still think it's a mixed bag, but on the whole, on an aggregate basis, they are a lot better than what one really thought they would end up reporting.
Your thoughts on IT and in pharma? You reckon that the top-down move is done, or is there still enough room in pharma as well?
So first on IT, I still think that they'll continue to witness some strong growth momentum. Clearly, the U.S. economy still continues to be very, very strong. Spending on technology continues unabated. And clearly, the currency is in favor of the technology companies. So I think a combination of these three really put it in a pretty strong position, puts the sector in a pretty strong position. But one needs to be really careful that if the currency stops, the dollar stops appreciating and say rupee gains back its strength, which could potentially happen maybe a couple of quarters later, one really needs to see at that point of time whether the technology sector is able to continue to post such strong margins. I think that continues to be a strong watch area, I would say. Coming to pharma, I think this space is now becoming interesting. And that's purely because I probably think pharma was where technology was 2 years back. Difficult to time it. You're not able to kind of time it saying this is the bottom and things are going to look positive. You probably run the risk of getting into the sector a bit early on. It's quite possible pharma could go through that. It's tough to say right now whether when this will happen. But what I can see right now is that there is really a consensus that the sector continues to face a lot of challenges. Pricing pressures are there. Regulatory challenges are there. But in the process, the base is coming down. And I think that probably could augurs well for the sector, maybe with a slightly more longer-term horizon.
But I wanted your thoughts on one space where there have been growth guidance upgrades coming in, the commercial vehicle space and the tractor space. So we've seen the likes of M&M, Escorts, Ashok Leyland all raise the growth forecast for the next year. Does that make you bullish?
I think I'd probably be more bullish on the CV segment versus the tractor segment. The tractor segment really has, in a sense, posted great numbers after a couple of years of bad numbers or not so great numbers. And we have to keep in mind that this is a cyclical business.